when you look at the numbers, they've exceeded the estimates, and brokerages like CLSA are bullish. They maintain their buy stance and are giving a target price of 515 unchanged. So these kind of numbers were actually supported by a robust subscription number this time, thanks to a new tariff order which we saw, part of which will trickle into Q2 itself. But the ad revenue growth, that one slumped to low single digits, and management is giving just a subdued commentary even for Q2 on that front. They do expect things to revive in the second half of this year, and are hoping that 20% kind of number on the ad revenue growth can be achieved. Though on the subscription revenue, they believe that numbers will be slightly better, though not as strong as what you've seen in Q1. The key catalyst for the stock, however, is going to remain the promoter stake sale, which is just a few days away. As of now, they have received one binding offer, and they're expecting another one to take it forward in the forthcoming days. So the stock valuation right now is at 17 times FY20 earnings, which is a 40% discount to its 10-year average, and therefore CLSA believes that the risk reward is actually skewed in to go long. If you look at Credit Suisse, they have a neutral stance with a target price of 400, bumped up slightly from the earlier 390. While the Q1 is still strong according to them, and we've seen a 10% beat on EBITDA, they believe that the working capital investments, which are going to increase to about 500 crores for Z5 originals, that is something which is going to weigh on the overall balance sheet, and this number may remain high for next year as well, given the kind of investments we are seeing from other OTT majors, from Netflix, Hotstar and others. So therefore, while they have raised their estimates by 2-3% this year, they believe that it's best to stay neutral until we see progress on the deal ahead.
Right. Thank you for that, Pranay. And yes, everyone is keenly awaiting details on that strategic stake sale. To discuss that, Punit Goenka, MD and CEO, joining us this morning, Z Entertainment Limited. Mr. Goenka, thanks so much for being with us. The street is and has been keenly awaiting details on that strategic stake sale. You have mentioned a timeline of up to the end of July. Is that something that will be adhered to? Is that still a timeline that you're keeping to?
So we've already received one binding offer on the stake sale. We are expecting another binding offer in a matter of days. And I'm pretty confident that we'll be talking to you in a few days' time to reveal which way the family is going to look at for the stake sale.
Okay, so let's also understand the impact of the TRAI tariff order and revenue growth in Q1. What has that been? What has bolstered profits for you in this first quarter?
So we are quite glad with the outcome of the tariff order. As you can see, our domestic subscription revenue has grown 47%. We do expect that the growth will continue to happen for the entire year. We are forecasting, based on certain deals that are yet to happen with the DPOs, that this should be on an average growth of about 25% plus for the full year for the company.
And how much did the monetization of Z5's content and investment in traditional movie content hurt margins? And will margins manage to stay above 31%, or do you think there will be a dent?
Margins will remain above 30%, and that does factor in the peak investments that we are making both on the broadcasting business as well as Z5. And we are pretty confident of delivering that for this year, this full year.
Right. And Punit, did the cautious spending by advertisers hurt your ad revenue as well? And do you think ad revenues will continue to remain soft going forward too?
So ad revenues will definitely improve. We are seeing some improvement in quarter two, but not anything great. But overall for the industry, for the year, I expect it to be high single digits or maybe low digits. And as usual, we will beat the industry growth as we've been doing in the past.
So what is the outlook on the subscription revenue? Do you see an increase in realizations boosting your ARPUs?
No, definitely it will improve our ARPU, because as you will recall, that our realization from DTH per subscriber was much higher compared to cable. And what this tariff order does is actually gives it a level playing field, that we have to price it commonly between all platforms. And therefore, we will see an uptake in our ARPU levels. Well, ARPU levels for consumers has gone up. It will improve for the DPOs as well as for us.
Punit, there is the Z5 franchise is off to a good start, but you know, when a breakthrough technology comes out, competition also increases. You got global players like Disney, Amazon Prime, Netflix is also putting in a lot of money in terms of content. Balaji and the tie-up with Reliance. How do you see things moving in terms of the competition and the competitive landscape?
So content has always had extreme competition in this country, whether it was in traditional television and now in the OTT space. So I'm not really worried about competition from that angle. I think the criticality of the business is who creates good quality content that the consumer wants, and therefore that they will be the successful ones rather than just by launching new OTT platforms. It will have some short-term impact on content cost for the OTT platforms, but as usual, given our expertise in localized content, not just in Hindi or the national language, but also the regional languages, we do expect that Z5 will continue to have its edge over its competition.
Okay. Also, what has been the growth in monthly active users or time spent for Z5, since we're talking about that particularly, just to get a sense of how the platform's doing?
So monthly active users as of June end stands at about 76.4 million monthly active users. Given that we are only a year-old platform, our daily active users are still lower than industry averages. We are only about 6.6 million daily actives. Our time spent has improved from 30 minutes to now about 36 minutes per user per month. And we are quite confident that we'll only keep improving from here.
Mr. Goenka, thanks so much for joining us and sharing our details on those numbers with us. And we also look forward to news regarding the strategic stake sale. Let's take a very quick break. We'll continue to bring you excerpts from that conversation and track some of the other big earnings that we're looking at today. Back in just a minute.